live with himself, cause I'm see you. Everything was going fine until he screwed up. So while he's doing him, baby girl, let's do it. She tell me, say she has
feelings.
She tell me, say she deep in her
feelings.
She tell me straight up, say she
like me.
But when she see me, she get full of
anxiety.
Her ex-man is up in his
feelings.
Because I had her looks up in her
ceiling.
Him call her, run him, tell her him can't. But she don't want him no more, cause she loves him.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. So let me know how y'all digging this quality though. Do y'all see this quality of this camera? Okay. Yes, y'all got me a new camera. I got a Canon T6i. And when I tell you I love this camera, my honey was hooped and hollering because I did buy another camera. And I didn't need another one, so she says, but I feel like I needed it. But let me know how y'all like that quality though. So in this video, we're gonna be doing this nice, sexy royal blue eye. You know, I never really do a waterline highlighter, but I have been feeling kind of dark lately. Ooh. So we did this nice smoky blue eye, and you know I love me my nude lips. I'm gonna start throwing some colors out, but yes, I just feel like I had to just throw on a nude lip. So if you like to see how we got this nice sexy glam face, just keep watching. Moving right along to my favorite part, I'm going to be prepping my skin. And yes, y'all, I'm on vacation for 9 days and my sisters are coming. We lit. So I'm just gonna apply my luster drops to my strobe cream just for extra radiance. And I'm just gonna apply this onto my face and make sure it's completely smooth so it's not patchy. Y'all know I need to moisturize my lips. I have the driest lips living in DC. Like, maybe it's because the air changed, but Lord, my lips are so dry. And I'm going with my same old peach luster, correcting under my eyes and the hollows of my cheeks because that's where I have the most hyperpigmentation. You guys see why I love this peach luster? I have it all on my face, but it doesn't look orange. And look how amazing it neutralizes. Like, some people I know wear this by itself as a highlighter. But it's bomb, y'all. Invest that $27, y'all. It's bomb. So I'm going in with my Studio Fix Fluid in the shade NC47 with my Marc Jacobs Face 2 brush, which I am in love with. I'm going to get another one. I know they came out with another brush, so I'm going to definitely invest in that. And I'm just going to press this foundation into my face. I'm going to be using my Pro Longwear Concealer in the shade NC45. I used to think this shade was not light enough for the highlight that I want because, you know, your girl like a dramatic-ass highlight. But it's actually really, really pretty. It's a softer highlight. I'm used to something like NC42 or, you know, Warm Honey and LA Pro Girl. So I actually like the NC45. Now I'm just setting it with my Banana Luxury powder under my eyes, and you guys know I set my eyes one at a time so it doesn't crease. And I'm using my Beauty Blender Pro Sponge just to press that in. I'm using my Studio Fix powder and just dusting that over my face with my Morphe powder brush and going in with my Sun Power bronzer with my Crayon Case Judy brush. So y'all, this is the same steps that I have been doing in my last, I think, 4 videos that I posted. I really don't change these steps. So to make these videos shorter, I'm just going to be zooming by it so it won't take forever and it won't be repetitive with the same things. Now when I do try a new product, I will definitely explain it and tell you guys how I like that product, but for now it's the same old same old. So to contour, I'm going to be Contour Book. I love this because I love the shades, and it comes with 2 highlighters and 4 contour. Y'all, I love the shade Ruddy, and I use that just to give me a little bit more definition in my bronzing. You guys know I do not contour for structure, just for warmth. So I'm just dusting that right on my cheeks. Now going into brows, I love my Great Brown. I love it. I love it. And I have been using it wet, so I spray my Fix Plus on the mirror part of my brow powder and just dip my angle brush, and then it makes it into a perfect cream, y'all. Perfect. And sorry that my camera is doing this autofocus craziness. I have to figure out why it's doing that. It's probably because I'm moving too much. Now I'm going to be using my MAC Studio Finish Concealer and NC42 just to conceal my brows. And I use this concealer also as my eyeshadow base, so it's like my two-in-one. But sometimes I'll pull out the P. Louise just so my lid shadow can have more of a pop to it. First of all, if you have a GPS on your woman, you know your lane. Second thing, you're childish if you play those type of games. Third thing, I just love the way she ride the sugar cane. Fourth, you're not put up with the bullshit again, girl. My lover, you move your body when you're next to me. Me love your flaws and everything about your girl. You're such a queen. Such a queen. Next time he's stalking you from other pages, blowing up your messages, you know what that means. Your ex upset, cause him see you. Him can't live with himself, cause him see you. Everything was going fine until he screwed up. So while he's doing him, baby girl, just do us, do us. Starting with eyeshadow, we're gonna go in with the shade Soft Brown from MAC. And I'm just going to use that on a fluffy blending brush, and I'm going to place that right in my crease. And remember, my concealer is still wet, so I press that first before I start blending, just to build up the color, and then I'm going to buff it out. Guys, this is also an amazing transition color. Like, this is one of my all-time favorite transition colors. It's super neutral, but it still works well with warm colors and cool colors. So if you have never tried Soft Brown, try it. It is literally one of my absolute favorites. Next, I'm gonna go in with the shade Saddle. It's another neutral brown that is super pretty for everyday wear. So I'm gonna place that right, same place in the crease where I placed the Soft Brown, and I'm going to definitely concentrate that in my lower crease. So I'm not gonna blow it out as much, but I'm just gonna concentrate that so I can start building up the depth. Bet it's Sunday. Watch how we flip it. Watch how we flip it now. Jack Frost. Your ex upset, cause him see you. Him can't live with himself, cause him see you. Everything was going fine until he screwed up. Of course, I had to use this base because I'm doing a royal blue and I want that color to pop. So I'm just going to place my P. Louise base just on my lids, and I am going to just press that in and pack it on, because that's how she says you're supposed to use it. You're supposed to pack it on. And then I just blend out the edges, and then I'm going to apply this royal blue from MAC. It's called In the Shadows, and it's such a beautiful royal blue. Like, I don't really wear blues or cool colors that much, but this is something I'm definitely gonna be wearing again. First of all, if you have a GPS on your woman, you know your lane. Second thing, you're childish if you're playing. And honestly, guys, I'm not like as bold as I used to be. Like, I will do cut creases and colorful looks, but I'm so into like classy glam. Like, like a glam that a freaking congresswoman would wear. Like, I love colors, I love the bold looks, I love all of that. But now I'm so starting to feel like I like classy glams, like still full coverage but more softer eyes with a little bit of a pop. I don't know. I guess I'm adulting. Is that what that's called? I don't know. But don't get me wrong, I would still hit y'all with a two-piece with that, with them cut creases and glitter, but I'm just starting to like, you know, red carpet glam, like Beyonce glam, okay? You still get the beat, but I don't know how to say that. But don't underestimate me. I will still throw out the cut creases for you guys, okay? So now I'm just starting to soften out the edges because they were a little bit harsh, and I'm just starting to build out the outer corner of my eyes just so it can have a little bit more depth. Now I just applied a little bit of black eyeliner to my waterline, and I'm just gonna smoke out my waterline just a little bit. I used to do them like super black. I just wanted to do like a very, very subtle black, not as dark. But next time when I do the shadow, I'll do like a very deep, smoky, like dark brown. So I'm just using my MAC, my dual fiber brush, just to brush off the excess fallout and also brush off my setting powder. And then, you know, gotta go in with the blush, MAC Raisin Blush. It's just my favorite red blush, and I feel like it goes with everything. So I'm just using that on a Morphe contour brush. And y'all know, I gotta slap on that highlighter. I am using Crayon Cases Honor Roll Highlighter on my Sephora fan brush. So this is my lip combo. It's going to be the Mariah Carey collection in Rainbow Interlude, and my absolute favorite NYX Peanut Brittle Intense Butter Gloss. Y'all, this is the best nude gloss, and it's completely full coverage. It's like a lipstick in lip gloss form. Like, when I tell you the intense butter glosses from NYX, that's one thing that they will never and should never take away. Like, they did that for this formula. Like, I'm so obsessed with these butter glosses. Like, I think I have every color. So if you have not tried this, please try it. I promise you. And I've used it with my Cork liner, one of my favorite liners, lip liners from MAC, Cork. If you have not tried Cork, you need to try it, okay? I feel like I'm the lip ambassador because I love lips. It's my favorite feature on my body. So now I'm going to drench. And when I say drench, I'm going to drench my face with my MAC Fix Plus with gold light in it. And I love this formula. Like, I love this setting spray because it has like little gold specks in there, and it just gives you a nice dewy highlight. And you know, mascara before lashes. Gonna pop them lashes on. So this is how I get my highlight to pop, like extra pop. I always apply it after I spray. I do another application. So when you apply your highlight.
All right, guys, that was it for the look. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you got something informational and you got something that you can add to your makeup routine. Let me know what y'all want to see. I'm gonna keep saying that. Be sure to subscribe to my other channel where I'm gonna be vlogging, cooking, working out. I'm gonna have some secrets to tell y'all, and that's just gonna be the tea channel, okay? So like literally everything I do that's entertaining besides makeup is gonna be on that channel. So make sure you guys click down in the link below and subscribe to your girl's fun channel, all right? And I will see y'all in the next tutorial. Bye.